hope is what makes us strong. It is what we fight with when all else is lost.
I am an example of what can happen when you quit being afraid to gamble. Shook the dice and rolled. When niggas like you on the stage shook and froze, I get busy. Yeah. You think you know, you ain't sure. Fool.
Nick the Beast is your boy, got the sauce like soy. Just want to thank the homie Bryce White for letting me know Gully Boy uploaded a suspect rap lyrics part 4. You already know, I had to do a reaction to it. These videos are always the funniest videos. And it'd be crazy, because they really be saying some sus stuff, you feel me? But we gonna check this video out, you feel me? Without further ado, let's get that thing started, my nigga. All right, you already know you gotta start off with the classic 50 Cent, you feel me? You already know. Don't mind the jacket, it's just cold in the house, you feel me? 50 Cent!
Coming in at number 10, we have someone who was long overdue for being on this list. Long overdue. I'm not saying that 50 has a library of suspect lyrics, but he has quite a few. And in 2007, 50 Cent did Lil Wayne and Birdman on the track called Part-Time Lover.
You can go and do your thing. You wanna fuck a miss with me.
Now, the concept of this track is somewhat unique, as 50 disses Wayne and Birdman through conversations with his female companion. Okay. Sounds harmless, right? Well, that's until you hear the lyrics.
It's more than your body, baby. Damn, it's your brain. You make me wanna kiss you like baby kiss Wayne, and make you call me daddy like baby Dwayne.
Okay, now I know this is supposed to be a diss, but why is he thinking of two men kissing while getting intimate with this girl?
You make me wanna kiss you like baby kiss Wayne.
How often do you have dreams about men kissing?
That's a good ass question, bro. Like 50, bro, explain yourself.
Damn, that shit sounds gay, it's insane.
Yeah, bro, you right.
You already know
that
I had to rock the Boondock shirt, you feel me?
Well, I guess I'll give 50 a pass on this one because, I mean, at least he admitted it that it was gay.
Yo, your ass fat like Joe. You real sweet like Ja.
Wait, what? You know what? I'll just take that pass back. Did you just say that girl was sweet like Ja Rule?
I think he's a sweetheart for real. Come here, give me a kiss, you little faggot.
Alright, alright, alright. I had enough of this shit. Let's just move on.
AK? I did the race.
Okay, this next lyric is a rapper whose music I actually really like. Like, this man's music is so good, I wish they would set him free so he could drop more music. Now, I know that's a pretty coonish thing for me to say, but if you watch my channel, then you should already know I don't give a shit about what you think. Anyway, just in case if you don't listen to Tay-K's music, his subject matter oftentimes consists of selling drugs
and
killing
people. I've honestly only heard the race
song
to keep it
love
solid.
My chopper, Tay-K opens up about his emotional and physical attachment with this gun by saying things like,
I don't tell no chopper, bitch, the chopper told me. I love my chopper and I think it love me.
But what he says next is borderline suspect.
So FN if I sap it, but I'm 16. He think he hard, what a chopper beat is me.
Hold up.
Man, play that shit back.
He think he hard, what a chopper beat is me.
Okay, I guess I can.
I know what that nigga means,
like, all he's really saying is that if a dude tries to act tough, he's going to shoot him with this chopper. But the way he says this is just weird. I don't think I've ever heard somebody
say,
you think you hard? Don't let me make my chopper jack you off, nigga.
He think he hard, what a chopper beat is me.
No homo.
Boys talking down. Yeah, we call them haters. I'm balling right now, so we'll get to that.
They almost made me sit out this motherfucking lemonade.
Popular trap rappers of our time. His dedication to the culture has rewarded him with a cult-like fan base and
crazy.
An influencer within the trap music genre. And in 2006, he would collaborate with T.I., Young Dro, Big Country, and BG on a song called Top Back Rumors.
Yeah.
And on this song, Young Jeezy says something very questionable.
What does he say Monday.
Ice cream and bow, same color as a sun. So you can miss me when they're hating and that he can't rap shit. Tell them faggot ass niggas wrap their lips around my dick.
Come wrap their lips around my penis. I mean, you couldn't come up with the line less suspect. I mean, he could have easily said some shit like, and tell them,
whoa,
keep a bad instead, he would rather them to perform oral sex on
them. Tell them faggot ass niggas wrap their lips around my dick.
How is he not number one, bruh? Hey, yo. Hey, that nigga should have been number one, bruh.
Okay, the funny thing about this,
that nigga not fat no more. That shit funny.
Appearance on the second part of my worst diss track.
Man, still went to a wedding with a Wingstop cup, though.
Horrible diss track and a suspect rap lyric. Like, I can't make this shit up. Anyway, for those of you who don't know, between the years 2008 and 2009, 50 Cent and Rick Ross got into a very serious beef that led to multiple diss tracks. And I can proudly say that all of Rick Ross's diss tracks were complete garbage. And on a diss track called Push Him Over the Ledge, Rick Ross disses both 50 Cent and G-Unit and says the gayest shit imaginable.
Get money, homicide is what it come with. We the killers, motherfucker, who you gonna get? I handle homo solo.
Wait. You handle what solo?
I handle homo solo.
I mean, I don't think there's another way to interpret this. Like, anytime he's in the presence of a homosexual, he likes to handle them all by himself. And if you think this is bad, listen to what he says next.
Lloyd Blanks, I know you wonder why I ain't say nothing about your bitch ass, but you sucked your assistant dick on tape and he leaked it.
Hold on, bro. If this is true, how the hell would you know? Like, did you watch this so-called sex tape of Lloyd Banks and his assistant? Because if you did, boy, you gay as hell.
You're a fucking dick-sucking faggot. Niggas homos. Y'all could Google it.
Did this nigga just suggest that I go Google some gay shit? Man, get this nigga off my
Rick Ross? Baby, you've been rolling solo, time to get down with the team. Hey, I like this song, too. Hold up, bruh.
Okay, before I get into this next lyric, I just gotta say that UGK is one of the most legendary rap duos of all time. Their contribution to the rap game has inspired many artists today.
That's international players anthem.
Are still appreciated today. During UGK's career span, Pimp C passed away, rest in peace, and Bun B went to establish himself as a solo artist. But no matter how legendary you are, if you say some suspect shit, you're getting put on this list. And with that being said, on a track called Tell Me Something Good, Bun B says something completely out of the ordinary.
Tell me something good. What did he say though?
Hey yo, what's up with that bulge in your khakis?
Whoa. Did you really just ask another dude that question?
Hey yo, what's up with that bulge in your khakis?
Now a lot of people might say that Bun B is probably a gun. Not having a gun. But I would have
but
to
still,
disagree.
That's...
Only because of how he said it. He said it as if he really would like to know if the guy's really packing downstairs.
Hey yo, what's up with that bulge in your khakis?
Nah, man, I'm
cool. Oh, no. Ice Cube?
All right, just in case if you guys didn't know, Ice Cube was one of my top 10 favorite rappers of all time. The way he tells stories in his music...
I got Ice Cubes in my drink right now. Hold on, bro.
And in my opinion, he has never lost a rap battle. Which brings me to this next lyric, which comes from the infamous diss track,
Might have to stop using Ice Cubes.
Goddamn, I'm glad y'all set it off. Used to be hard,
it's from I've heard this song 1,000 times, bro. What did he say?
Now, if you don't know the history behind this,
I've heard this song so many times, bro. What did he say?
Or you could just watch the movie Straight Outta Compton. But with all that being said, there is a line in this track that's highly unusual.
The bigger the cat, the bigger the pillage. Who gives a fuck about a punk ass villain? You're getting cut real quick. An easy dick. It's smelling like MC Ren shit.
Wait. How the hell would you know what Eazy-E's penis smelled like? And secondly, how the hell would you know that Eazy-E's penis smelled like MC Ren's asshole?
An easy dick is smelling like MC Ren shit.
Man, hold up, I don't do that gay shit now.
Okay, this next lyric ties in with the previous line from Ice Cube. Now, the NWA and Cube feud started because Ice Cube was not happy with his contract, which led other members to believe that he betrayed them. And one of those members was MC Ren.
Hey, yo, this is MC Ren from NWA, and you back with me on Out West, you know what I'm saying? That fool Ice Cube put a diss on this record, yo. Hey, but why don't y'all tell me what
I wouldn't
you think
be
about
rapping
Ice
about another man's dick in a song,
you know what I'm
keep
saying?
It
That's
solid,
what time
solid.
It is, you know what I'm saying?
Now, although one of his ways of venting his frustrations was gathering up his homeboys and punching buildings with the word ice written on them, he would also take to the studio. And on a skit called Message to Benedict Arnold, MC Ren tells listeners what him and his crew is going to do to Ice Cube when they see him. And in my opinion, it's one of the gayest things I've ever heard.
I smell pussy.
Yeah, nigga, when we see your ass, we gonna cut your hair off and fuck you with a broomstick.
Bro, why couldn't you just stop at cutting a man's hair? Why you gotta be on that prison yard shit? All right, let me ask that y'all this. If a man isn't gay, would you think he would want to involve himself in a scenario like this? Because if you would, you got a little sugar in your tank. No,
like,
fuck that.
For real?
A whole lot of damn
it's not the same thing, but that's...
When we see your ass, we gonna cut your hair off and fuck you with a broomstick.
Like...
You know what I'm saying? That's what time it is. You know what I'm saying?
Pause.
You know what time it is. That nigga said pause. Yo, this is crazy.
Here we have another suspect lyric that evolves around someone beefing with Ice Cube. In 1995, Cypress Hill would accuse Ice Cube of stealing lyrics from one of their songs. And when Cube found out that he'd been accused of this, he dissed Cypress Hill with a track called King of the Hill.
Every few years, niggas think they can deal with the real. Now I got to fuck Cypress Hill.
Cypress Hill then responded to Ice Cube with a diss track called Ice Cube Killer. And within this diss track, B-Real says something very suspect.
Four W fingers and stick it in Mac 10 cents and lick it. Ice Cube is a thing of the past. If I got no nuts, it's because they still smack in your ass.
Okay, you know what? I get it. B-Real is saying this because Ice Cube said that he had no nuts on King of the Hill.
Cinder, you can't rap from the guts, and B-Real sounding like he got baby nuts.
The other reason why he's saying this is because Cube supposedly stole his lyrics. But no matter the reason, the shit still sounds wrong.
You're the king of punks, king of busters, king of thieves. Now get down on your fucking knees.
Damn.
Stop the sucking.
Okay, now that's just gay.
And of course, is this nigga naked, bro?
Hold up.
Notorious B.I.G.'s on this list again.
Notorious B.I.G. Like, what would this series be if this man wasn't on it? Anyway, this lyric comes from a
track
called
Dead Wrong. My man's told me he was on this list.
After Biggie's death.
But what did he say?
Take notes while I take totes of the marijuana smoke.
This is one of Big's more popular songs, as the instrumental slaps hard, and his wordplay and lyricism is top-notch. And the remix also features Eminem, which makes for a deadly collaboration. But just like the majority of Biggie's tracks, he says some straight-up, off-the-wall suspect shit.
Slit the wrist, a little sis. After she sucked the dick, I stabbed a brother with the ice pick because he wanted me to fuck him from the back. But smalls don't get down like that.
Okay, now for those of you who don't know, the premise of this verse is him going on a killing spree and killing anyone that crosses his path. So he stabbed a guy because he wanted to get duked in the ass, which Big then says he doesn't get down like
cool.
That. Then he proceeds
but
to fuck a man with a broomstick. Nigga, you just said you wasn't with that gay shit. Then you turn around and do some gay shit. Like, what the hell is this dude's problem?
Because he wanted me to fuck him from the back. But smalls don't get down like that.
Yo, this is crazy.
Got your father hiding in the room. Fucked him with the broom.
Gay shit.
My top's bad. Yeah, I got my top's bad.
Okay, coming in at the number one spot, we have a lyric
Soldier
from
Soulja Boy.
Soulja
Boy.
I don't really know the whole backstory behind this lyric. Other than that, Soulja Boy and famous Atlanta producer Zaytoven are close friends that helped each other elevate their careers. The lyric comes from a song called Phone Call, in which Soulja Boy shares some strange details about his relationship with Zaytoven.
Call all my fucking niggas up.
Call them niggas.
And tell them it's time to rhyme. See, Zaytoven, that's my nigga. I've been fucking him forever.
Excuse me?
Yo, what the hell? This shit ain't even suspect.
That's
this shit
flat
really
out.
Is just downright gay. Like, this man literally just said he's been fucking another man forever. Like, damn, my nigga. Forever? What kind of shit is that? Now, the thing that triggers me the most
shit like
is that
these, weird nigga.
The gay shit was said.
See, Zaytoven, that's my nigga. I've been fucking him forever.
Yeah.
This right here is a clear indication that he went back and heard the gay shit he said and improved it by adding the ad-lib. Like, did this dude have somebody in the studio with him to correct this shit? Shit, I guess not. And for that, he rightfully earns the number one spot on this list.
See, Zaytoven, that's my nigga. I've been fucking him forever.
Shut up. Oh, I listen to you. Yo. Oh my gosh, bruh. I can't believe it. Like, Soulja Boy. Damn, bruh. If you guys like the video, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. Share this video with your friends.
I need to cleanse my mind. I need the Men in Black bin. Go.
Stay high, spatial levels, I'm Marvin the Martian. Squad like the Transformers, yeah, we all sparking. Haters dogs with no bite, man, they just barking. Had to show them that I'm better by a large margin. The beat in flames, bruh, I'm committing arson.